Hey everyone, welcome to my latest stories in a song video here on YouTube. Well, I got my blue and white checked shirt on here for a special reason today. This is the closest shirt that I own that comes closest to the type of shirts that John Fogerty wears on stage when he performs. And he used to perform as CCR and now performs as a solo artist. Because today I'm doing a song by CCR, Creedence Clearwater Revival, called Lodi. This song was written by John Fogerty and released in 1969. This is my first CCR song on my YouTube playlist, My Karaoke Songs, and my 281st video on there in total. I first heard this song on a TV infomercial for this two-cassette collection, which is right here. Whoops, I just lost the tape out of it. The best of CCR, Creedence Clearwater Revival. This is what started it all for me, way back in 1993, when I was about 18. I saw an infomercial for this on TV, and boy, I fell in love with this group the first time I heard them. And including Lodi, along with the rest of the songs featured on this infomercial. As it was playing, that first time I told my parents that I wanted to get the tape for Christmas or my birthday, whichever came up next on the calendar. I had never heard anything quite like CCR before, either the music or the voice of its lead singer. And since 1993, I have amassed a collection of CCR and John Fogerty material that includes every album that I know of that has been released since then. And that is this huge pile right here. Woohoo! I can't even hardly hold this thing at one time because it's so big. Man, that's a big pile. We got one I just showed you there, Best of CCR, then we got John Fogerty, Blue Moon Swamp, his first solo album in about 10 years at the time, from 1997, this was. Then we have an older album on tape called Center Field, John Fogerty. That was one of his previous albums that he put out before Blue Moon Swamp. He had one also called Eye of the Zombie that I'll show you in a minute. And then we have this tape, Premonition. That was a live recording that went on a tape and a CD. And now we have 20th Century Masters, the Best of John Fogerty. This includes CCR and solo stuff. So does Premonition also. And we have a more recent album here, John Fogerty and the Blue Ridge Rangers, Rides Again. That was his country album, more or less. And here we have Deja Vu All Over Again. Another album, a CD by John Fogerty. This one from 2004. And here is the album that came before Blue Moon Swamp, that was a lot of years before, Eye of the Zombie, from 1986. He took a big old hiatus there for about 11 years until he came out with Blue Moon Swamp. And this is probably the most recent album that I've got of John Fogerty. It's called Fogerty's Factory. That is his family band, with his daughter and his two sons, and himself, of course, where they performed a lot of old CCR songs, plus John Fogerty solo stuff from later years. And there's more. Revival, John Fogerty. Another album by John Fogerty, a CD. And one more CD called Wrote a Song for Everyone. That's one of the old CCR tunes that didn't get a whole lot of publicity back in the day, but it's included on this album here called Wrote a Song for Everyone, where he performs songs with a lot of bands and artists who were influenced by John Fogerty and CCR in more recent years. And now we have DVDs. The Ultimate Live Collection, CCR, Creedence Clearwater Revival, Down on the Corner. These are clips from back in the day when CCR was big, between 1969 and 1970, mostly. And no more DVDs. John Fogerty, The Long Road Home in Concert. Right on. And there's more. Here's the Premonition one again. The DVD version of Premonition. And then we have coming down the road. Yeah, the concert at Royal Albert Hall. And that's a more recent one. Even though they did play at Royal Albert Hall back in the early 70s, I believe. CCR did. And now I have a book, which is John Fogerty's memoir, Fortunate Son. My Life, My Music, John Fogerty. Which I'll be reading a few passages from here as I go along. So, getting back to this stuff here. Let me see here. So here's a bit from John Fogerty's memoir about the origins of Lodi, page 169. Okay. Flipping here to page 169. The origins of the song Lodi. How did it come to be? It says, Lodi was just a title for a long time. The inspiration was those trips with my dad to those small towns in Central California, a place that I felt very warm and special about. I had already started to transfer my feelings about that place to the mythical Louisiana swamps I'd been writing about. It was also childhood. I was moving place and moving time, going back to when I felt really special and good and homey. It felt like me. Somehow I got the idea of a traveling musician, probably a country guy, but older. A guy whose career is in the rearview mirror. The kicker is, quote, Oh Lord, stuck in Lodi again. That oh Lord tells you how he feels. I was 23 writing this song, a very young man who just had a million-selling single all over the radio. That has nothing to do with the well you were drawing from when doing your craft. One of the people I love is John Steinbeck and the rural world he created, especially the Grapes of Wrath. When you're a kid, you're doing what you do. You don't say your name in the same breath as those gods. You're just a punk kid trying to do a new thing. What's funny is, passing through Salinas, I actually wrote down some of the street names in case I ever wanted to touch on all that. I was fascinated with that literary territory, but that research came out not in a specific, but in an emotional way. It came out in things like Lodi. All right. And now from the next part here, the song Lodi describes the plight of a down-and-out musician whose career has landed him playing gigs in the small town, small agricultural city, called Lodi, California, in California's Central Valley, about 70 miles from John Fogerty's hometown of Berkeley, California. After playing in local bars, the narrator finds himself stranded and unable to raise bus or train fare to leave. Fogerty later said he had never actually visited Lodi before writing the song. And simply picked it for the song because it had, quote, the coolest sounding name, unquote. The song unquestionably references the town's reputation as an uninteresting farm settlement. The song's chorus, Oh Lord, Stuck in Lodi Again, has been the theme of several city events in Lodi. John Fogerty also stated, quote, On Lodi, I saw a much older person than I was, because it is sort of tragic telling. A guy is stuck in a place where people really don't appreciate him. Since I was at the beginning of a good career, I was hoping that wouldn't happen to me, unquote. The song's arrangement includes a change of key in the final verse of the track, emphasizing the melancholy drama of the lyric, If I only had a dollar for every song I sung. And so on. Now here's a little bit of info about John Fogerty as a songwriter. I'll have more to say about him in the artist bio section later. Fogerty has written or co-written 72 songs that have been recorded by more than one artist, including Lodi from Brown Eyed Girl, originally by the Gollywogs in November 1965, to Mystic Highway, originally by John Fogerty on May 28, 2013. Mystic Highway was on that album, Wrote a Song for Everyone, that I showed you guys there. The brown-eyed girl that I mentioned is not the same brown-eyed girl made famous by Van Morrison. The Gollywogs was a name that CCR went by before they became CCR. All but one of the 72 songs were originally recorded by John Fogerty or a band that he was associated with. That one exception was Lodi, but more about that later. Fogerty's most covered song is Proud Mary, which has been covered by 360 artists. Lodi is sixth on that list, having been covered by 82 artists. Lodi is my first John Fogerty written song on YouTube. I'll have more to say about the cover versions later. The original recording of Lodi was made by Cajun Gib Guilbeau, an American Cajun country rock musician and songwriter, in 1968. However, his version was not released until October 1969 on his Strawberry Records single, Home of the Blues, as the B-side. Home of the Blues was originally recorded by Johnny Cash in the Tennessee 2. I will have that song on a future video, as it's on one of my Johnny Cash CDs. About 7 months before Guilbeau was released, in March 1969, CCR recorded what was essentially the first cover version of Lodi at RCA's studio in Los Angeles. Bad Moon Rising was also recorded at the same session. The recording was in the country rock, rockabilly, and soul genres, produced by John Fogerty, and arranged by him as well. The song Lodi was released on April 15th, 1969, the original release of the song on Fantasy Records as the B-side to Bad Moon Rising. A review in Cashbox Magazine's April 26, 1969 issue stated, quote, "Louder and bolder than Proud Mary, the new Creedence Clearwater side picks up where their last one leaves off, but with the immediate impact to eliminate another long work buildup. Blazing Bayou Rock outing, which should carry the group back up the top 40 lists," unquote. Oh, there's more. Lodi, on the other hand, is closer to Mary in its style and presents equally strong programming material. Both sides are powerhouses, unquote. Another review in Billboard Magazine's April 26, 1969 issue went, quote, "Two blockbuster sides from the Proud Mary group. Loaded with rhythm and drive, the top side can't miss going right to the top. Equally powerful for top play and sales is the easy beat Lodi, with much of the feel of the recent smash," unquote. Lodi did not make it into the top 40, topping out at number 52 on the Billboard Hot 100. It also reached number 58 on US Cashbox and number 59 in Canada. Lodi was included on CCR's third studio album, Green River, released on August 7, 1969 by Fantasy Records. Bad Moon Rising / Lodi was the first single from the album. Lodi was track 2 on side 2 of the album. The rest of the album, besides Bad Moon Rising and Lodi, I got Blue Moon Swamp in my brain now, was recorded at the then newly opened Wally Hyder Studios in San Francisco, finishing in June 1969. So all the other songs besides Bad Moon Rising and Lodi were recorded at Wally Hyder Studios. Personnel who played on the album were the four members of CCR: John Fogerty on lead and backing vocals, lead guitar, piano, keyboards, and harmonica, Tom Fogerty on rhythm guitar, Stu Cook on bass guitar, and Doug Clifford on drums. John Fogerty was critical of Clifford's drumming on Lodi in his book, and that is on page 188. I'll read another little section here about what he says about the drumming of Doug Cosmo Clifford on this song, Lodi. Page 188, here we go. It says, "Then there was Doug. Doug was a rock and roll drummer. It wasn't finesse, it wasn't jazz, it wasn't quiet and subdued. It was kicking you right in the face, which is what I wanted. He had pretty good tone most of the time. That's important, but it just wasn't real polished or professional, and sometimes I had a problem with his timing. The drum break on Lodi comes to mind." Yep, he wasn't too satisfied with the way Doug Clifford drummed on Lodi, but he fixed it. He fixed it himself. But for now, here's a little bit about the cover versions of Lodi. 100 cover versions of Lodi have been recorded to date, making it the 58th most covered work of all works released in 1968. Hey Jude, originally by the Beatles, is number one on that list with 598 covers. I'm only familiar with 20 of the artists who have covered it, and one of those artists I was mistaken about. I had thought for many years that I had heard Anne Murray sing Lodi on the radio shortly after my first hearing of CCR's version on the infomercial. But I guess the fog of time had shrouded my recollection because In preparing for this video, I noticed that Emmylou Harris had covered it, so I listened to her version on YouTube, remembering that the version which I had thought was by Anne Murray had a drawn-out ending to the last word in the song, sort of like, "Stuck in Lodi again." That's how Emmylou Harris actually sang it at the end, which, as I thought about it, sounded a lot like Emmylou Harris. Turns out, Anne Murray has never covered Lodi, and it was in fact Harris who I had heard on the radio. 78 of the 100 covers are in English. 9 are instrumentals. 2 are in Dutch. 2 are in Finnish. 1 is in Korean. 1 is in a language I've never heard of called Limburgan. 1 is in Spanish. 1 is in Swedish. 1 is in Portuguese. 1 is in Serbian. 2 are in Norwegian. And 1 is in Frisian, which I think is a language similar to German. I'll start off with the only version I've ever heard of, ever heard, aside from CCRs. That is by American country and folk singer-songwriter Emmylou Harris and the Nash Ramblers in January 1992. A live version on their Reprise Records album, At the Ryman. It was recorded live at the Ryman Auditorium, April 30th to May 2nd, 1991. Other English versions by artists I am familiar with are by American R&B and soul singer and musician Al Wilson in July 1969 on his Soul City single with B-side By the Time I Get to Phoenix, made famous by Glen Campbell, by American country singer, guitarist, and songwriter Buck Owens on December 29, 1969, a live version on his Capitol Records album The Buck Owens Show Big in Vegas. It was recorded at the Bonanza Hotel, Las Vegas. By American singer and songwriter Bobby Goldsboro in December 1969 on his United Artists Records album, Muddy Mississippi Line. By American country music singer-songwriter Buddy Allen, son of Buck and Bonnie Owens, in February 1970 on his Capitol Records album, Wild, Free, and 21. By UK pop and R&B singer Tom Jones in October 1970 on his Decca album, I Who Have Nothing. By American influential singer, guitarist, and songwriter who was inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame in 1987, Bo Diddley, in 1971 on his Chess album, Another Dimension. By American country music singer and songwriter Justin Tubb, son of Ernest Tubb, in 1972 on his Cutlass album, Travelin' Singin' Man. By American pioneering country rock band The Flying Burrito Brothers, of which Gib Guilbeau, who made the original recording of Lodi, was a member, featuring Graham Parsons, the American singer, songwriter, guitarist, and pianist, in 1973 on their A&M Records album, Honky Tonk Heaven. And Emmylou Harris had a close professional relationship with Parsons, and of course, nearly 20 years after this, recorded and released her own version of Lodi. And by American pop artist and songwriter Lobo in May 1974, on his Big Tree Records album, Just the Singer. There are 90 more cover versions of Lodi. Now here's a little bit about my personal all-time favorite rock and roll band, Creedence Clearwater Revival, commonly abbreviated as CCR or simply Creedence, was an American rock band formed in El Cerrito, California. The band consisted of lead vocalist, lead guitarist, and primary songwriter John Fogerty, born John Cameron Fogerty on May 28, 1945, he's now age 79, He was born in Berkeley, California. His brother, rhythm guitarist Tom Fogerty, who was born Thomas Richard Fogerty on November 9, 1941, in Berkeley, California. He died of HIV/AIDS and complications with tuberculosis, which he contracted from a blood transfusion during back surgery in the 1980s, on September 6, 1990, in Scottsdale, Arizona, aged 48. Bassist Stu Cook, born Stuart Alden Cook on April 25, 1945, now he's 79 years old as well, born in Oakland, California, and drummer Doug Clifford, born Douglas Raymond Clifford on April 24th, 1945, one day older than Stu Cook, also age 79, in Palo Alto, California. Clifford is nicknamed Cosmo and is the namesake of CCR's Cosmo's Factory album. These members had played together since 1959, first as the Blue Velvets, then Tommy Fogerty and the Blue Velvets, until 1964. That year, they signed with Fantasy Records, and the label's co-owner, Max Weiss, renamed them Vision. For the band's first release, Weiss renamed them again as the Gollywogs, after the children's literary character Gollywog, which name they kept until 1967. That year, Saul Zaintz, who John Fogerty would face in later years battling lawsuits in court, bought Fantasy Records and offered the band a chance to record an album. Having hated the name The Gollywogs from day one, the band decided to call themselves Creedence Clearwater Revival in January 1968. The name's elements came from three sources: Tom Fogerty's friend, Creedence Newball, to which name they added an E, as in Creed, a television commercial for Olympia Brewing Company, which quoted Clearwater in the commercial, and the members' renewed commitment to their band for the revival section of the name. The band performed in the swamp rock, roots rock, blues rock, country rock, southern rock, and folk rock genres. The band carried on with the same four members until Tom Fogerty left for a solo career in 1971. CCR disbanded acrimoniously in late 1972. John Fogerty was at odds with Clifford and Cook over matters of business and artistic control, all of which resulted in lawsuits among the former bandmates. John Fogerty refused to perform with the two other surviving members of the band. The band has never publicly reunited, although they did reunite a few times, once for an album done by Tom Fogerty in 1974, once in 1980, and once in 1983 for John Fogerty and the three surviving members, all three of their high school reunion. John Fogerty refused to perform with the other two surviving members of the band. But John Fogerty does continue to perform CCR songs as part of his solo act, although he did go through a period of more than a decade not performing them at all, while various lawsuits were ongoing. Cook and Clifford performed as Creedence Clearwater Revisited, with a different lead singer and rhythm guitarist, from 1995 to 2020. I saw Creedence Clearwater Revisited live in London, Ontario, at a music festival at the downtown Harris Park in my old hometown, London, Ontario. I can say that I had an unfavorable opinion of their show. John Fogerty's voice is irreplaceable, and the musicianship just didn't measure up to the original CCR. Fogerty had the closest thing to the original in the late 90s and early 2000s, with Kenny Aronoff on drums, Billy Burnett on rhythm guitar, with Bob Glaub on bass, on John Fogerty's Blue Moon Swamp album and his Premonition album also, along with the concert video for Premonition and the Long Road Home concert video. Those were probably the best versions of old CCR tunes that I've come across ever. So if you ever want to get those, be free. They are awesome. CCR's discography includes 7 studio albums, 5 live albums, 41 compilation albums, 29 singles, 14 B-sides, and 7 music videos. None of their singles reached number 1 in the US, although 5 topped out at number 2, and another hit number 3. 17 of their singles reached the top 40. If you include all countries of the world, the band had 9 number 1 singles. 887 records were released on Creedence Clearwater Revival between 1968 and 2022. As the Blue Velvets, they released 6 singles between October 1961 and June 1962, and as the Gollywogs, they released 23 singles between mid-1964 and October 1967. CCR was inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame in 1993 by Bruce Springsteen. And now, after all that, I'm going to sing Lodi. All right, let's get to it right here. Lyric sheet over here with me, because some of those lyrics aren't quite right on the screen. So here we go now. Lodi by CCR, written by John Fogerty. Let's get it on. Woo! Just about a year ago, I set out on the road, seeking my fame and fortune, looking for a pot of gold. Things got better, things got worse, I guess you will know the tune. Oh Lord, stuck in Lodi again. Rode in on the Greyhound, I'll be walking out if I go. I was just passing through, Must be 7 months or more. Ran out of time and money. Looks like they took my friends. Oh Lord, I'm stuck in a low die again. Woo! Yeah. A man from the magazine said I was on my way. Somewhere I lost connections. I ran out of songs to play. I came into town, a one-night stand. Looks like my plans fell through. Oh Lord, stuck in Lodi again. It's a key change, folks. If I only had a dollar for every song I've sung, every time I've had to play while people sat there drunk, you know I'd catch the next train back to where I live. Oh Lord, stuck in Lodi again. Stuck in Lodi again.
Woo! Take it home, John Fogerty and CCR. Yeah. CCR, Creedence Clearwater Revival from 1969. Woo, boys, that's my all-time favorite song by CCR, the first one that ever got me hooked on the band, and I still love it today. Woo, 30 years later. All right. Well, I can say that that's going to do it for today, but I sure did have a lot of fun singing that song and telling all those stories. Hope you all enjoyed watching and listening to them, and I can say that I'll be working on my next video coming up on Sunday. And that one is going to be back to the old country songs. It's going to be called Saginaw, Michigan. It's a song by Lefty Frizzell from the old way back in the 60s. So be here next time because I ain't even started yet. Have a good day now.